Hey, welcome back. You're watching Trending SA on SABC3 and on TrendingSA.tv online. Thank you so much for all of your Facebook posts. We love hearing from you. Okay, so let's see what you're saying about us on Facebook right now, shall we?
We love hearing from you.
This is from Olenkili saying, guess who's... Hey, Wena. I've seen like six tweets and Facebook posts. Guess who's wearing a belt? Dr. Musa Tombeni!
Shine! Okay, why are you wearing a belt today then?
You know, when the enemy comes like
oh
a flag.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, Jesus!
Thank you.
Lepanta, as my people would say. All right, do we have another post? Hey, Dr. Teller, where did you get that shirt? What does the baby have to do? I'm so confused. The baby's looking at your shirt.
And shock heads.
No, there's nothing wrong
with
the shirt.
Trying to focus.
The baby's puzzled. That baby looks 75 years old. How does that work?
It's that shirt. That baby saw that shirt and wrinkled up.
Okay, you can send your memes, you can send your comments, anything live on air. Tweet us, comment RT like you know. The hashtag to use is TsaOn3. Wherever you choose to speak to us. He's wearing a belt, guys. Over to you, Lepanta.
It's to distract himself
like
from
I said, shirt. When the enemy...
To distract
They
us.
Come like a flood. But of course, let's get into it. The first hashtag may be a bit unfamiliar to most people who saw a trend today, but I thought let me introduce you to the man behind hashtag Keith Rose. Now, he's recognized as the father and icon of television advertising in South Africa. And unfortunately, today, he passed away. Thus, the hashtag RIP Keith Rose. It popped up on the timeline. His illustrious career, of course, was in advertising, and it's seen him being accredited with some of the most important and groundbreaking commercials in the country. And even after his 30-year-long career began, South Africans weren't really too sure what he did or who he was. But look, he was in the film and television advertising kind of world. And he did the things that needed to be done. Now, with the passing of Keith Rose, tributes from people in the ad industry started to pour in. And of course, a dedication video was put together to sort of highlight the work that he's done over the past few years. Like I said, you might not know who it is, but I'm sure his adverts or all the commercials that you've seen of him definitely made it into this tribute video. If you're confused about which one it is, take a look.
Problem here. Falsco. You never call my name.
Now moving from one legend to the other. And of course, we're talking about superstars in South Africa. The hashtag Super Mega with his hashtag AKA World App trended today after Kenan Forbes, announced via his Twitter account that he's launching a new app. So just a few hours ago, he launched this reality app that exists, but put a pause on things just for a second. Listen. You remember when the Super Mega did sort of weird things yesterday, saying all kinds of weird stuff on his Twitter when he tweeted the following things? Right, so let's get into what he actually said, right? The story is about him leaving the Beam Group. He said that there were a couple of issues that he's had with some of the people that he's working with, but he's closing down the business, but not necessarily, you know, leaving the business in itself, if you get what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? So he's still the owner, but they're no longer managing his day-to-day activity. So this is the tweet that he put out, and I want to show you something. All right, unfortunately, I have to announce that Beam Group now no longer represents or manages me in any capacity. While I remain the owner of the company, I'm actually in the process of shutting it down. All right, of course, another tweet continued to say, we started the company with the best of intentions. Unfortunately, it's just not working out for me the way I wanted it to. So I'm taking my ball and going to play elsewhere. Now, all the best to you, Mr. Forbes, on your new app. And let's hope it turns out and becomes a success that you want it to be. Yeah. That's it for today's updates. I'm out of here, buddy.
Skirt, skirt.
Bye, bubble.
I think it's quite exciting.
What?
Owning your own business. That's amazing. Doing the thing, you know?
But I love what he said, that he is the business.
Mm. Yeah.
That's very cool.
He's not a businessman. He's a business.
Because I was wondering why he had tweeted them, because they tweeted something and he responded to them and said, guys, you're embarrassing yourselves.
Ooh.
Next. Well, snap, snap, snap.
Okay, so early this morning, actually, graveyard shift early. Who's ever been on graveyard shift? Yeah. Right. Mm-mm. Okay. So the rest of us were asleep and like a shuffle in the big parliamentary house, a late night announcement was made. Big Concerts is bringing Dave Chappelle to South Africa! Andale, andale, andale!
Arriba!
Show Charlie Murphy. I'm not finishing that sentence.
Okay, so he's finally coming to South Africa for his first ever African tour. And it would seem that everybody is excited. The tour will include 3 shows around the entire country, starting off in the mother city of Cape Town. They're moving to KwaZulu-Natal for a show in Durban. And ending it off, Gauteng Maboneng, Dave Chappelle is coming to Joburg. So his stand-up career started in high school. Fun fact, when he got booked for gigs, his mum would have to accompany him because he was too young to go to the clubs and to the shows alone. Aww. In the 90s, Chappelle hit the big time when he started gaining recognition for his work in the comedy circuit. And he made his debut in a film in the 1993 feature, Robin Hood, Men in Tights. Nice. Give us a quotable.
We're men in tights.
That's how it goes. We're men in tights. Something like that.
So go check that movie out. In 1994, he was the youngest comedian ever to be featured on the Comic Relief 6 show. The entertainer has come a long way. He is best known for his groundbreaking television sketch comedy show, Chappelle Show.
He certainly came a long way from that hat.
I enjoyed that hat. After a very successful 3-year run, he quit the Chappelle Show. He was offered like zillions of dollars and he ran away out of the public eye. And it was later revealed that he had made a hideout here in South Africa. Can you believe it? He returned to his farm in Ohio to escape the stress. The stress that was the high life of being Dave Chappelle.
Being rich and famous, was it aimless? But also during his time away from media, he really gave Amandusa interviews. He hosted small comedy shows and he would ban usage of cell phones during his sets. The only way to experience Chappelle's comedy during his hiatus was to see him live in the moment and in that moment, alone. Selfish.
Look, I mean, then, what's going on?
She was so angry with him.
Why are we so angry with Chappelle?
The hiatus.
You know, he's an artist. It was then time for Dave Chappelle's return to television in 2016. And he returned to Saturday Night Live in his first appearance. And he got a standing ovation from that tough crowd in New York. Chappelle's SNL monologue was nothing but exactly his vintage style. Have a look.
To say that Black Lives Matter. Now, I admit that is not the best slogan, but McDonald's already took You Deserve a Break today. And I guess it's kind of catchy because everyone else is biting it. Even the police bite it. Blue Lives Matter. What, was you born a police? That is not a blue life. That's a blue suit. If you don't like it, take that suit off, find a new job. Because I'm going to tell you right now, if I could quit being black today, I'd be out the game. I did the next best thing. I became a rich black person, which is harder than you think because, you know, your life becomes gentrified, like Brooklyn. All your black friends start moving out and all these new white friends start moving in.
Now, Bobby mentioned that last year, Dave Chappelle celebrated 30 years in the industry. And in celebration of this phenomenal milestone, last year he released 4 stand-up specials on Netflix, which were accompanied by a double feature vinyl comedy album. Now, the 45-year-old has since been nominated for 2 Emmy Awards as well as a Grammy.
Guys, I mean, just to think about that volume of work to put out, the opinions you have to form, the way that you have to craft those jokes, the amount of time and energy that you have to use to like test those gags. Like, you know, living in New York, there's comedians that'll do like four, they call them mics a night. So you'll find Chappelle at all of the clubs testing his material, club after club after club. He'll leave Madison Square Garden and then go and test material straight after the show, you know? I mean, the impact that he's made on the industry, you know, now that Trevor Noah lives in that space and we have access to Robbie will go to New York and hang out with Trevor and be like, yo, you know, Chappelle and whatever. Like, it's like 2 degrees of separation for us now, which is so remarkable, and it makes such an impact on us. And as an urban youth community, you know, like it's really, I mean, he's our hero. He really is.
I love the way his mind works. Yeah. The fact that you can put, you know, those comedians together, like a Chris Rock, a Richard Pryor, and now a Trevor Noah in that space. Right. Dave Chappelle is delightful.
So you're going to the concert then?
Well, I'll be here presenting this concert to you on TrendingSA. In celebration of Dave Chappelle coming to South Africa, we've put this thing together to hype us all up. Bugelan.
I'm going away for a little while, all right? I'm going to live with a white family. Y'all be good.
What you going to be doing with a white family?
It's a TV show. Say hi to America. Anybody try to touch your mother? Punch him in his dick.
Look, son, Dad's going away for a few weeks, so I want you to be good, okay, Squirt?
Whatever.
I love you.
Eskimo kisses.
It's too much to stress you out. This whole world is drug-infested, hate-infested, drug-infested world. Hate drugs. I heard the worst drug story. You know what my friend told me? You know what he's dealing with? His landlord is hooked on crack. That's terrible. That's pressure. Your landlord's hooked on crack, that means you've gotta have the rent. He come around all the time. I got the rent. It's not even due yet, it's the 10th. Come on, I need it! Let me just get $20 of it now and then just give me the rest of the end of the month. Every couple hours, hey look, I'm gonna need some more of the rent. This building's falling. Can't handle pressure. Sometimes pressure make me talk different. I'm serious. You ever have like that social pressure? You ever talk to somebody who's fake and they make you fake? Like, they come to you like, hey, how you doing? And you're like, fine, how are you? And you're like.
It's so
we'll
good.
See you after the ad break. We'll so see you after the ad break. So we'll see good. You after the ad break. This is Trendy.
I know it could have been bad, but now everything Gucci, she act like a groupie, she already know who I am. I pull up with the scheme and a couple of beamers, so now we go fuck up your salaries. Headed by such a chick in my heap, I will show up and all of the witches just follow me. Headed by the Matiba, Matiba, the ring at it, rudely, little, it's a sakane. Headed by the Matiba, Matiba, but never let you, little fella, chungane. I came up from the dirt, and I trip on my birth. It's a gift and a curse, but it could have been worse. I didn't know the puppy. Here it's for my deep, and I bust all the feet. I'll set it for B. I'm as rich as they wish that they could have been. If she check all the numbers, we pulling it. If she sit on my lap, I'ma fuck up and check. I spoil all of my women with jewelry. Buy a Chanel, ooh. I treat her well, ooh. Give her enough to buy for herself and buy for a man. Ooh.
Oh my god. People up and bite like 20 bottles in a spot. All my niggas, Liddy, we got any 7,000. Run it, then it, then it, and it cost like 7,000. Cost like 7. Sazo I'm giving my
my zone. I'm selling my queen. Keep it below. Yeah, Safaguchi. I'm bamboo my crease. I see young tanner young thing. Yeah, I'm bamboo young squeeze. I'm assuming you know how I get around. I'm a player, I'm never gonna set it down. Gali limela, mama, yashele, la Niger, the Senegal, London, etc. You might go to my son, like a general. I'm too rich for my quick at the cinema. Taking fun, I lift it, lift it, lift it, lift it, cause I'm telling you, I love my women though, yeah, all of them centerfold, yeah, ain't talking magazines, yeah, I make a centerfold, ooh, I let her finish though, ooh, that got a limit more, ooh, love of a touch of the dude is so softly, me, Juanjo, so molino! I'm a bad motherfucker, I eat you for supper, if we got a problem, we'll see you more, jump on another papa before we want to...